my channel. So today for you guys, I have some Dollar Tree kitchen DIYs. I have not done a kitchen DIY in a very long time, and I've only ever done one of them actually, and it was last year. So I hope you guys enjoy these DIYs. I want to say this, one of them is inspired by Crafting with Maria. I will link her down below for you guys. It popped up in my newsfeed on YouTube, and I saw it, and I was like, oh my gosh, that looks cool, but I want to do something for a kitchen. So I did something similar, not exactly the way that she did it. So if you want to see the way she made her bigger one and it's for the bathroom, I'll link it down below. I didn't go out at all to buy any of these supplies. These are supplies I had at home already. And then I was like, what can I do with this to make it work for my kitchen? So I hope you guys enjoy the video. If you do, please give it a thumbs up. Let's see if we can get this video to 5,000 thumbs up. And make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel if you're not. And click the bell button so you're notified every single time that I upload. Let's begin the video. This DIY, I'm going to be using some paint mixing sticks I got at Home Depot. Each pack cost me 98 cents. There's one that is on the smaller side. There's 10 pieces in that one, and then the bigger one comes with 3 pieces. Now I'm going to be attaching the wood using wood glue, and I'm also going to end up using these baskets that I got from Dollar Tree. Now I'm going to use the baskets to figure out where I want to place the sticks that are going to be holding the baskets before I attach any of the wood glue. Now you can use these wooden plaques that Dollar Tree carries instead if you're trying to use all Dollar Tree products, but honestly it's just cheaper to go and get the mixing sticks, because if you use the wooden plaques I'm talking about from Dollar Tree, you're going to need at least 6 of them to do it, so that's $6 right there. On top of that, you can even get a cheap, inexpensive, bigger, thicker piece of real wood at the hardware store. I've done plenty of ladders on my channel, one using only Dollar Tree products, another one using Dollar Tree and Walmart products, and then one using just real wood from Home Depot. So if I remember to link them all down below, I will link them just so you can see other options. This one is done a little bit differently in the setup of it, but you just use kind of the same theory that I'm using in the other ones and just make it look like this. So I use 2 of the larger sticks as the sides of this little like ladder basket holder, and then 5 of the smaller sticks as the sticks that are going to be holding the baskets, and then just something cute at the top. Now I didn't end up cutting the piece that's at the end of these sticks where it kind of like goes in a little bit. I just left it the way it was. If you want to cut that off, you can do that, but your ladder is going to be a little bit smaller. As you see, I'm using wood glue. You don't have to use wood glue if you don't want to. You can go ahead and try to use smaller nails or a staple gun. It's up to you. Wood glue for this though worked fine for me. If you're going to be putting a lot of weight on the baskets, then you want to be thinking about using something with the wood glue like the nails or the staple gun. I forgot to mention the painting sticks are like rulers, so one side doesn't have inches on it, the other side does. I decided to leave the part where there are inch markings facing toward me because I like the way that it looked. After the wood glue has completely dry, I started to stain the wood, and I realized I forgot to close the door, and then Pepper came out on me and I was just like struggling to get her to move. I had to take my gloves off and everything to get her out and then close the door. And then I continued staining. The stain I'm using is from Varathane. It is their dark walnut stain. I got it at Home Depot. This dark walnut is very different than the Minwax dark walnut. The Minwax dark walnut color is much more darker than this one is. I actually really like this color though. Now you don't have to use a wood stain. You can always just use an acrylic paint, and if you want it to look like a wood stain, just water it down a little bit. Once your wood stain has dried, you can then attach your baskets. I'm using zip ties to attach my baskets. They are from Dollar Tree. Dollar Tree does carry different sizes of zip ties and also different colors. They carry zip ties in red, clear, and black. I'm using the bigger black ones for this. You could use the clear ones if you want. I just felt like the black ones would blend with the baskets nicely. And then whatever I stuck in here was going to cover the zip ties anyway. You can always paint the zip ties on top of that if you want to. You can use something else, I'm sure, to attach the baskets. But this is just the easier way, and still trying to use as many Dollar Tree products as I can. You want to use at least 3 zip ties to attach each basket. Next up, I'm taking these wood letters from Dollar Tree, and I am just going to spell out kitchen above the little like ladder thing that I made. I don't even know what you call that. Basket holder?
don't know. Before I glue the pieces down, I go ahead and place the wood letters first to make sure I get the correct spacing that I want, and then I glue them down using my wood glue. You can use a hot glue gun to do this if you want to. You can also paint the letters. I decided not to paint the letters. I actually liked that unfinished wood color with this, so I just didn't paint them at all.
And that's it for this basket storage holder. It depends on the weight that you're putting inside of the baskets. So everything I had in my baskets was very lightweight. I was able to use command strips on this. But if you are going to be putting things that are heavier inside of those baskets, you just want to nail this to your wall. You could put some nails in your wall and then just hook the top of it over the nails. You can put nails through this thing if you want to. It's up to you.
Next up, we're gonna make a little like Lazy Susan spice holder, whatever you want to call it. So Dollar Tree does carry Lazy Susans. They look like this. They're just plain white, almost like an enamel looking white, and then they spin real easily, at least in my case, because I've heard some people have issues with these, but I've never had an issue with them. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a cake pan from Dollar Tree, and I just painted it white using white acrylic paint. And I'm going to be taking some burlap ribbon, also from Dollar Tree, with this cute little pattern on it. And I'm going to glue that around the sides of my cake pan. And I'm just using hot glue to glue it down. You can use whatever glue you like. Hot glue, though, is perfectly fine for something like this. And I was able to get two rows of that burlap around the cake pan before I was like, okay, this is good enough. And then I added the burlap ribbon around the edge of my Lazy Susan. I should mention, with the cake pan, you don't have to paint the bottom of the cake pan, and I don't recommend painting the bottom because you're going to be gluing that to the Lazy Susan. So it's better to have no paint there because it attaches better without paint on the bottom versus with paint on the bottom. So now is when I glued the cake pan to the center of that Lazy Susan. Now, I recommend using like E6000 to do this, but I'm trying my best to steer clear from E6000 right now just because I'm pregnant. I don't want to breathe in those type of like fumes and stuff. So I'm using a hot glue gun instead to do this, but I recommend using E6000 or Gorilla Glue. Now I'm going to be taking some nautical rope from Dollar Tree, and I decided to add that right on the parts of the Lazy Susan that are still showing. So around that cake pan, I go ahead and I glue nautical rope around there. I use my hot glue gun to do that as well. And then I place some nautical rope on top of the cake pan, the edge of the cake pan. And that's all I did for this DIY. I took a very boring Lazy Susan from Dollar Tree and made it very farmhouse shabby chic. It's really, really cute, as you can see. So now I'm going to be recycling a DIY I just previously did, and I tend to do that a lot, and especially now that I'm home and I'm just trying to use what I have. So what I did is I took a canvas from Dollar Tree. They have different sizes. I'm using the biggest one they have, which is 8x10, and I'm taking the canvas off of it. You can probably just rip it all off without using pliers like I did, but I'm a weak girl. And then I went ahead and I painted the canvas. I used acrylic paint for this, and it was from Apple Barrel. Once I had my canvas all painted, I then took some rulers from Dollar Tree. There are two in a pack, and it's the wooden rulers. I take the sticker that is on the rulers off. They peel right off. It's where it says all the inches and stuff. They just come right off. Once I have the stickers off, I paint the back of the rulers white. Again, I just use an acrylic paint to do this. Then I took a scissor. If you have something better than a scissor, go ahead and use it. But I took a scissor and I cut it down to fit the back of my canvas. And as you can see, I didn't paint the back of the canvas because, like I told you guys earlier, if you're gluing two things together, it's better to have an unfinished surface versus paint on it. It just attaches more easily with an unfinished surface versus paint on it. As I said, this DIY is recycled from another video. And so when I glued these rulers down, I used hot glue to do it. And it was fine for that particular DIY. But for this spice one that I'm doing, I recommend using wood glue to attach those rulers, or little nails to nail the rulers into the canvas. If you don't plan on putting heavy spices into this, hot glue is going to be just fine. So I'm going to be using these small, narrow baskets that Dollar Tree carries. They're just wire baskets. And I'm going to be using one of them and attaching it to the image using zip ties. I'm using a clear zip tie.
And I just kind of figure out how to attach the basket through the zip tie where it would hold, stay in place. So I just kind of loop one of the zip ties around around one of those rulers, and then I just tied in the basket in place. You can use as many zip ties as you want to secure the basket. I only used two. I wasn't putting anything too heavy inside of this. Now, once I had the basket all set, I then took these poster stickers from Dollar Tree and I spell out spices at the top of this image. When I take these stickers, I don't automatically kind of push them down into the ruler. I first just kind of lay them out and then I space it, get the correct spacing that I want, and then I like use my finger to really work it into the ruler. Now, Dollar Tree carries rub-on stickers that I actually would have preferred to use for this, but because I know I want to use this image at least one more time for another DIY, I didn't want to put the rub-on stickers, otherwise I wouldn't be able to reuse it for another DIY. Obviously, you could put whatever you want inside those baskets. I actually use these small little mason jars from Dollar Tree for this. There's two in a pack for $1. I'm using three of them. Two of them I actually ended up putting spices inside of, and then one of them I ended up putting just some greenery in there. It's super cute, and this could be nailed to your wall if you want it to be nailed to your wall, or you can use command strips, as long as, again, you're not putting a bunch of weight, because when it comes to command strips, if you put a bunch of weight on a command strip, the thing's gonna fall on you no matter if you made the thing or not. The next DIY, I'm going to show you how to do something that I already have in my kitchen. So from Dollar Tree, you want to pick up one of their foam wreath forms as well as some greenery. Dollar Tree does carry these boxwood looking leaves. There's 7 stems to them. At Target, they also have these ones for $1, and those ones from Target look better to me. They're more realistic looking to me, and I had more of those on hand than the Dollar Tree ones, so I ended up using those mainly for my wreath. So what you want to do is you want to take the greenery off of the stem, and you probably want to cut down the greenery into almost individual pieces, like individual pieces of leaves, because you're going to get more bang for your buck this way and get it to spread out all over the foam, versus if you were just going to use one stem from each bundle that you got, because then you're only going to have like 7 stems, you're only going to have 6 stems. So you want to cut it down so you get more stems versus what it comes with. And then you want to glue it. Okay, so the Dollar Tree ones you have to glue. Those stems are plastic. The ones from Target, just the very top is plastic, but the rest of it has a wire, so you're able to cut it down and poke it through the foam. Whereas, like I said, the Dollar Tree one, you can't do it, and that's why you have to glue it. But I recommend, honestly, gluing each piece down, even if you're able to directly push it into the foam. Add a little bit of glue, it helps secure it into place. So I was able to make my wreath for $5, $1 for the actual wreath, and then $4 worth of greenery. And so there's 2 ways you can do this. I'm going to show you how I hang the wreaths off of my windows. Basically, what you need is just some twine. I've got some from Dollar Tree. Depending on your window setup, the blinds, or whatever it is, you might be able to get away with just twine. For me, I have to use these clip rings that I got at Walmart. I think they were like $3-4 that I paid for them. So basically, you take your twine, wrap it around the wreath, and then you would tie it to the clip ring. That's if you end up having to use a clip ring. If you don't, you could tie the twine directly to whatever it is you want to attach it to. So this is how I'm able to hang wreaths off of the front of my blinds. For me, all I did is take the clip and then I clip it to the front of my blind, and then it just lays there, and I have this really pretty wreath that's already laying in front of a blind. I hung the Dollar Tree one up in front of a bigger window, and I was having a really hard time recording it. I don't think it did it justice. The greenery kind of looks really washed out. I think it was just too bright or whatever. The other thing you could do is get a command strip from Dollar Tree. This one is from Dollar Tree, and put it on your cabinets, just as long as the wreath is not in the way of you being able to open up your cabinets. So I already have a wreath on another cabinet and it looks really, really pretty. So I want to talk about how much I paid for those wreaths. I did this one for $5, as I said, but you know what, wreaths, you can get them for an inexpensive price. This one I got for $12.99 at Home Goods, and then the one that's actually on the window I got at Ross for $9.99. so if you don't feel like making a wreath, you can go to a store and probably get one for an inexpensive price as well. Next up, I wanted to do a paper towel holder, so I ended up getting this bank from Dollar Tree. Now, I really liked the whitewashed wood look on the edge around the bank, so that's why I decided to use it. Into that bank, I placed some stones that I got from Dollar Tree. You need weight so that the paper towels aren't tipping over when you're pulling them or whatever it might be. Once you got the stones in, you add the cardboard backing that bank came with, and you could place the paper that it came with onto the back, which is now kind of like the top of your paper towel holder. But instead, I'm using this wood stationery paper. I liked it better. I thought it went better with the bank. So I go ahead, take that cardboard piece, trace it onto my stationery piece of paper, and then I cut it out. This paper I got from Michaels, and I think I paid around 25 cents for it when it was on sale though. Normal price, I think it ranges around 69 to 79 cents. I don't remember exactly. Once I had that piece of paper cut out, I add some glue to the cardboard piece, and then I glue down that piece of paper. Now, Dollar Tree does carry paper towel holders. They're just like a metal paper towel holder. I mean, you could just buy that and call it a day. That's up to you. I'm not doing that, obviously. So with that metal paper towel holder, I go ahead and paint the bottom of it white because I knew that the edges of it would be showing once I attached it to that bank. So I wanted it to blend in more nicely. So I just used white acrylic paint to paint the bottom of it white. Now, you want to use, for sure, a heavy-duty glue like E6000 or Gorilla Glue to attach your paper towel holder to that bank. And not every part of the paper towel holder, I don't know how many times I said that, is going to attach properly to the bank. So you don't want to add glue all around the bottom. You just want to look at where it touches the bank and then add glue there. Like I said, you want to use a heavy duty glue, and I'm pretending to use a heavy duty glue because, as I said earlier, I don't want to smell the fumes of that. It's a very strong smell, so I'm just pretending to do that. And that's it for the paper towel holder. You could just get the actual metal piece though from Dollar Tree if you want to and call it a day. It's up to you. So that is it for these Dollar Tree kitchen DIYs. I hope you guys enjoy them. They're very farmhouse chic. You can go ahead and change it up a bit to match your kitchen decor. Again, if you liked the video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any DIY ideas for me, leave them down below. I ain't got nothing to do. I'm home all day. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys next time. Take care. Bye.